Western Illinois Leathernecks battle the South Florida Bulls. Welcome, college basketball fans, to the Final Four. We're here in New York. This is Vern Lundquist with Bill Raftery and Tracy Wilson. What do you think, Bill?
The story here is a matchup at off guard. Huffman is one of the premier guards in the nation.
He's only 5'11 now. Huffman.
Creative with the ball in his hands. Schultz is also in the discussion of the nation.
God, he's 8 inches taller than him.
Absolute load to handle in the post. You can't push him around. Both of them are great competitors.
How can you not know your players' names when you only have like literally 20 of them? So it is like 10% capacity. God, they've sized down though. Come on, pass. No. Stop it. Bad. Meatballs.
McCollum.
Please don't do that.
Sochu catches it outright.
Wow. His mid-range game is generally solid.
He can't believe it, and I can't believe it. Pass, right wing. Number 52 backs in, takes the shot.
What?
Comes up empty from 20 feet out, and it's still knotted up zero.
Is it over? Is it under his nose or something? I'm not even. I didn't look at it.
Scores the opening field goal. Will come, and they lead by two.
Oh, I guess it is over his face. That's good.
Has it right wing. Skips it inside. Dupre, nice move. Big time rejection.
What are we doing?
Destroy this guy, but he will destroy.
Good. Good block.
The Bulls with the denial, and they lead by two.
He read that shot so beautifully. He knew exactly when to go up and get that one. Wonderful execution.
This game's going to be a clencher the whole way through, I have a feeling, so...
Inbounds the ball. Let's check in with our sideline reporter Tracy Wolfson.
Good D.
Just before the game, I talked to
I think it was We Want More.
The expectations that carries one of the favorites here. He said that pressure on his younger players is a concern. But he said what worries him more than that is his players listening to a week's worth of their own hype and forgetting that they still have to come out here and play good basketball. I guess that's a valid concern.
Thank you, Tracy. He makes the first.
We have a senior front court, two senior guards, a very talented small forward, and now really big with Tony Meatballs.
Huffman releases from 16 feet. Wow.
Beautiful.
Went after that rebound hard. Great work.
Oh yeah, it's literally right there.
Number 52 gets it.
He is a senior. So
he must have thought someone was rotating over to block that.
You can't lose concentration even for a second.
Sochu to the rim. The ball will land out of bounds after the errant shot.
Good defense from both teams so far.
Lau inbounds the ball. Feeds left wing, but it's recovered by Western Illinois. Dupre. Beyond the arc. Yanked down by McCollum. About 17 and a half minutes left in the half. Sochu takes it up. Lovely.
snatches the rebound. Can anyone score? Still down nine. There's been, what, one bucket so far, I think?
Dishes it to the wing. Passes it to the left. Loveless hands it off. Shot clock dwindling. It's deflected, and it's picked up by South Florida.
You can see him read it all the way.
Garnett hits it. And they're now out in front by two. Loveless gets it outright. Dishes left corner. Shoots it. Pulled in by Sochu. About
yeah, that is cool.
Left in the half. Garnett goes up.
No denying him on that one.
He's got five. Dupre dumps it off. Loveless catches it. Top of the key. Dupre bounces it to the left side. Left wing. Number 52. For three. Ripped down inside by Lovelace. Hangs in the air. Can't convert the layup. Huffman brings it up the floor.
Just threw it down.
His coach is going crazy on the sideline.
Eddie.
Flash up by McCullough. Lovelace inbounds the ball. Schultz, way up court. Schultz tosses it up. Can't put an end to the run. Just over 15 minutes left in the half.
Wilcox, grab that rebound. Almost high. Using a little intimidation.
Well, let's get back to the action. Loveless takes a three.
Well, you can't afford the spot.
Okay, not shooting is not good.
This game be over before the second half. It's stolen by number 52. Here is the break. Loud, the finisher. He gets hammered. Go ahead to the strike.
5 full minutes without field goals. Yeah.
I like that he's not afraid to be physical. It's too much.
The Kinde in for Dupree, I don't hate it. Also, you can tell it's more up to date because you're wearing a mask.
Goes up. He gets the second to fall as well. Huffman inbounds the ball. Garnett skips it to the left wing. Dishes to the left wing from deep. The shot was short by Huffman, but they're still up by 6. The Leatherman on the floor all time.
So while we didn't have like awful momentum or anything, I just want to make sure that we're going to pressure. I think tight on their front court is just an effective way to manage things. Oh yeah, I was just absolutely bonkers at that. Hopefully this goes well. I didn't look at subs, but we just pulled one person in. Not too worried about subs. We have a bunch of good people Wouldn't mind seeing Maxiel in there, though. Like, I should have bumped his minutes up a bunch.
Leads him with the pass. Slam down by number 52. That was a thundering finish. Why do they let them gain that kind of position?
Backfield violation. Step back over the midcourt line there. That's an over and back violation.
He just lost track of where he was on the floor.
Okay, yeah. I think these options are working out well. I think I made the right choices.
Bakinde. Passes it to the elbow. Backs down. Loveless. The leader. Hammered. And he
okay. Got bailed out there.
Second to fall as well. Wilcox inbounds the ball. Under 14 minutes left in the half. Skip pass, right wing. Wilcox puts too much on it. Still a 2-point lead. Left. Loveless. Backs in.
Nice work by the big fella to get that rebound.
Huffman brings it up court. From long range. Wilcox keeps it alive on the offensive end.
Don't like it when they get offensive rebounds, but it's been a lot better defense so far, at least. Lau trying to break him off the dribble, gets the move, gets the foul. Okay, that is amazing. They're going to show that clip 50 times on draft day. Yeah, like Tony Meatballs probably not sticking around in Macomb for another year.
Inbounds the ball. Under 13 minutes left in the half. Huffman. Passes to the right wing. Abram from the baseline.
Abram.
They increase their lead to 4. Schultz passes way down court.
Back court violation.
All right. Don't know what happened there.
He wasn't watching where he was on the court.
What the hell? Oh yeah, Tony Meatball's just skipping the payday of being a first round or lottery pick, which is like minimum 5 mil or something. It's like pretty good. NBA min draft contract. NBA rookie scale in real GM. Yeah, apparently if you're as low as number 5, your first year is 5 million, your second year is still 5 million, and your third year option is still pretty good too.
Shot won't fall. They're still up by 1. Dupre dishes it to the low block to take the lead.
gets it to go. And he's got a chance to add one more. He's either got a foul hard or don't foul at all. You can't just give up easy three.
There we go. The meatballs. The meatballs.
Packs on the free throw for the three-point play. Well, it looks like they're getting set to inbound the ball. Perkvic inbounds the ball. About 11 and a half minutes left in the half. Garnett
was a violation.
That's going to be over and back.
Obviously, that could have been avoided. That's just one of those mental mistakes that happens every once in a while.
Great pass. Number 52 rebound pass. All net. They're up 19 to 15.
Oof. Wish he was a little bit stronger to push him into the backcourt.
Dangerous pass. Terrific move.
Got the
That assist came from him knowing where his team was going to be before he got there. That's what's called chemistry, Vern.
Foul shot is good for a three-point play. McCollum inbounds the ball. McCollum gets it on the inside.
We're in a lead now. Yeah, this is... We're doing pretty all right.
Instead, he'll go to the line for two.
Shooting two.
Knocks down the first one. Second to fall as well.
Huh? Yeah. I mean, when Ismael Dupree doesn't like crash, when he doesn't blue screen of death, he's fine. Lovelace, that is not your play. I want him out of there. Fuck it. Get Maxiel in there.
Garnett behind the arc. McCollum gets the rebound.
God, who ate the foul? Meatball said. Coaching, subs, Lovelace, Maxiel, Lang, Meatballs, Lau, Paulding, and shift people up.
Contact as he tried to make the shot.
Yep, that's an open and shut case. He got hacked.
Shooting.
He misses the
substitution on the
court. Leathernecks will bring out some reserves. He sinks the second. Lau inbounds the ball. Bounces it to the left side. Schultz backs him down.
Is it highly tempting to speed on Iowa's roads when they're not frozen over? I wouldn't. They're maintained. As far as I can remember, they were maintained very well and incredibly straight, but they do have a decent amount of hills to them, so there are still opportunities for cops to appear out of nowhere. I'd recommend speeding in Utah.
No good from 3-point lane. They've still got a 4-point lead. Hexton dumps it off. Has it left side. Shoots the three. Good box out, and the board picked up by Lang.
Big rebound. The big fella's not afraid to do the dirty work, Burns.
The pinball dumps it to the paint. Out left. Lang, they're bringing the double team. Dupre throws it up. He's off with the three-pointer. But they're still out in front by four. Just over 8 minutes left in the half. Fires the three.
Huh.
No good. By Garnett. They're still down eight. Lang gets it. Baseline. Passes. Left wing. Lau catches it. Outright. Bakinde dishes to the wing. Top of the key. Dupre hands it off. Bakinde, the crossover. Dupre, and their drop. Gets it to go. He's shooting 40% from deep. South
substitution all time.
The Leathernecks will get a few of their starters back in the game.
So, how are we still up 7 after all that nonsense? Well, I'm answering my own question.
Passes to the left. Hangs. Grabbed by Abram. They've still got a 4-point lead. Deflected. And it's scooped up by Schultz. The D was really waiting for
him. How could he do that to his family?
South Florida is really struggling.
Oh my God. Hell. I'm sorry, I just heard awful news. Oh, it's is Iowa one of those places where it's so straight that they actually have to make it make a few right turns so it conforms with the curve of the earth? Because I know that's a thing that they have to do. Here, let me look. I know in, like, Wyoming, that's a thing they have to do. Like, if you look on, I think it might be I-80. Yeah.
Skips it down low.
He's got such fantastic court awareness. He's always going to find those openings.
Ooh, come on, push him into the backcourt. Come on. Ugh.
McCollum gets it on the free throw line. Skip pass to the free throw line. Abram.
Baseline J. Always good for that.
Schultz. Number 52 feeds it to the top of the key, to the stripe. Fires. No luck on the three-pointer by Schultz. But they still lead by four. Hexton. He's got seven. Dishes it to the left wing. Kinde passes it to the corner. Offensive rebound grabbed by Ludlow.
I'm pretty sure it's not good from three.
That's about the only way to stop him. Nice
little crossover. McCollum dumps it off. Hexton gets it left wing. Pass left side.
Lovelace. God, you have one of the best blockers we've ever fucking seen right next to you, and you do that. Oh my god. Please, just take him out, Lovelace. Maxio. Schultz. He's so tired. Lau? Yeah, Lau, just get back in. And Dupree for Bukinde, I guess. Not Butt. I don't want Butt in here. Paulding? Yeah, this is fine. Oh, God. This is going to be a tough little stretch, but...
a little bit, and this could be an excellent move. The group of kids on the floor play with great chemistry.
Three goals good, and we're all knotted up. Number 52, inbounds the ball. Hold it. The Kimbe bounces it to the high post. Number 52.
Good. That wasn't a bad move. I'm not even that upset.
The break is on.
9 times out of 10, he makes that. A little off, but not enough to deter him.
Good stop.
What? These fans are going nuts for him.
Woo! What a move.
That last basket was buried by Paulder. About 3.5 minutes left in the half.
What a solid move. Push him back. Come on.
Up his man. Abram hands it off. Heavy. Kanapka releases. Can't take the lead.
Tremendous rebound. He looks very comfortable under the glass.
Lau catches it left side. Feeds outright. From the baseline, snatched inside by Lau.
Can't forget about him down there. He'll gobble up all those offensive boards if you don't get a body on him.
Kanapka gets it right wing. Abram dishes it to the stripe out left. Kanapka with the shot. Nice dish by Kanapka. But they're still down by 2.
Do I have the... Oh my god. Ugly pass, Lau. No. No, I'll just let this happen and then do a timeout if they don't get my subs.
Shooting 2. He makes a substitution. Both teams are making substitutions.
Inbounds the ball.
Stay winning. Quinta to the wing. Quinta misses the long one. And it's still knotted up 33. Garnett has it outside. Peavy. It's a little short, but he gets the good goal. And they lead by two.
They've got their defense on it.
Wait a minute.
Has it on the strike. Holding skips it to the top of the key. Prato puts it up. Comes up empty from the wing. The Bulls with a lot of momentum.
Might have rushed that one just a little bit. There was plenty of time on the shot clock, but he got a little over-anxious.
Left wing. Tanaka. Hexton gets it.
I should have called a timeout.
20 feet out.
We probably would have still been in the lead.
Left side.
That was a fine look. Maxiel with the drive? Baseline. No, no.
Catches it. Baseline. Prato crosses it up. Lang yanks it down inside.
Okay, fine. Fine. Should have cut someone pregame. Would have been Lovelace. But we might need him next year.
Give us your opinion on the first half, Bill.
Both sides look like they're pretty evenly matched, Vern. This could be shaping up to be a real classic.
2-11, by the way. Your guess wasn't too far off.
And now it's time to show you our...
Oh my god.
Bill
Barnett is my pick, Vern. He's led his team in the first half with outstanding play on both ends of the floor. I don't think he's done, though. I expect more of the same from him in the second half.
We might need him next year.
Solid performance from our player of the half.
Hey, Nick. Yo, thank you for chilling. I'm glad that you could, come in and have some fun.
To start the second half. Sochu passes it to the free throw line. Garnett shoots, grabs the rock.
It can always get worse. Oh yeah, baby.
To the inside, they're going to
my Skelly crew outlasts like Luke's Skelly crew. I mean, like, it's only 10 where I am. If we win this, we're playing the next one.
It's still all knotted up. Garnett passes it up court. Huffman takes it up.
At least that's my plan.
Dupree fought for that rebound. That's some toughness for you.
Wilcox catches it down low.
McCullough with a great offensive rebound there. He worked so hard to establish position.
Dish, top of the key.
Zeeha! Cut day, best day. Zeeha. Oh boy, those fuckers.
Gets it on the free throw line.
Yo, Cindy, I appreciate it, but if you need to sleep, please sleep. I know you're probably still on some solid euphoria highs, but like, you know. I swear, if you take a step backwards, I'm pausing and calling timeout. Real, in universe, Coach Abby has like her hands always in the middle of the tee, like just ready to tee up, to just call timeout whenever anybody gets close to the doing a backcourt violation. What an ugly pass! God damn it, he's one of our best passers too. Oh my god. No. lucky. The chat here is good people. Yeah. Cindy knows I don't fuck around. I make good space. I try and do that. I don't care if it's a small space. I'll make it a good one.
Schultz has it left wing.
He's shooting 33% for the game. He's only shooting 33? Come on. Come on, push him back. Oh, we're not getting any pushback there. Maybe half-court trap is what we need? I'm down to try it. We need a defensive point of... What the hell? Defensive point of emphasis anyways. We'll go one more possession. I already regret it. Can't hesitate with these fools. These literal fools. Lovelace, get the fuck out of there. Maxiel, you're in. Paulding, you're sleepy. Get Lang in here early. Lau, Schultz, Dupree. We'll take the sleepier one out and put in Guy fucking Bukinde. A lot of bench movement early, but it is worth it. Pressure settings, I still want to make sure we are tight. Let's auto double. Let's auto double in the paint, their bigs. You guys are playing so badly, I'm not even bothering correcting you. Actually, it's going to bug me if I don't. Yeah, I mean, basically. We're going to try a half-court trap. Only on inbounds. See what happens. If it works, if it doesn't work well, we'll switch off.
Seal inbounds the ball. Bukinde hands it off.
Aha!
But it's tracked down by Bukinde. That last triple off the mark. How about the hustle of the little guys? Pulling it away from the big fellas.
My God, so good.
Gets it inside. Wilcox unloads from 10 feet. Lau hauls it in. That's his fourth rebound thus far.
He'll usually drop a shot like that. Don't count on him to miss it again.
Lau backs him down. Errant last shot by Lang. It's one on one. Takes it up. He's called for charging, and that's his third back.
When you're in foul trouble like this, it's impossible not to let it get into
substitution
your head
on the court. Abram is back in the game after a short rest. The Leathernecks still hold a narrow lead.
There's no question what kind of defense they're in, Vern. Minimum.
Bukinde dishes it to the right side. Lau pulls the trigger. Sedgwick gets the three-pointer to go. He's 1-for-3 from three-point range. Here comes the trap. Garnett. Bounces it to the high post. Fouled hard there. He'll get two free throws.
Shooting two.
And he makes the first. Second to fall as well. Maxiel inbounds the ball. About 15 and a half minutes left in the second half. Lang catches it down low. Lashley down low on that last shot.
No way he was coming up empty when he got the ball that close to the rim.
Bounce pass, right wing. Dicey pass.
Perfect use of the bounce pass for him. I'd like to see that.
Bukinde brings it up. Seal has it down low, raises up. Nice touch in the lane by Dupree. He's 3-for-9 for the game. He's double teamed.
All right, y'all. I just heard some. Oh my God! So the half point trap, half court trap, looks like it's working. Hell yeah! Yeah, this is working pretty well. Turns out that when you have people not exhausted 24/7,
he completes substitution on the court. Schultz is needed out on the floor. He didn't get much of a rest. McCollum inbounds the ball. The Bulls will take a timeout. Well, it looks like they're getting set to inbound the ball.
Oh, is it too late to rename Dupree? I mean, theoretically, I could do it. I could have done it last game, but you didn't do it. Like, I will rename him. I'm down to take your channel points away. Ooh.
Gets them both. McCollum inbounds the ball. Abram.
Carter Collins. You can change one of his names. He can be Ismail Collins.
Left in the second half. The defense did a really good job of closing out of the shooter back there.
Well, you have to stay in his face or he'll kill you.
Has it left wing. Number 52 puts it up.
Oh, okay.
Inside. Passes it to the right block. They still have a 7-point lead. Shoots it.
I can't take away Ismail from Ismail. No. I can't take away Don't Call Me Ismail from Ismail Dupree. It just feels wrong. But Collins is fine with me. Also, he's a shooting guard, just full disclosure. He's just playing there.
Catches it, right wing. Huffman connects. Huffman! He's got five. Lovely inbounds the ball. Just over 12 minutes left in the second half. Dupre skips it to the high post. Left wing. Schultz launches one from beyond the arc. Dupre corrals the miss inside.
Great offensive rebound. He works so hard to establish the position.
South Florida has had serious problems with their interior defense, and Tracy has a report from their bench.
The Bulls coach is definitely aware of that problem. He told his assistants that they have to bring more defenders into the paint, even if it means leaving the perimeter open. Desperate measures here, Vern.
All right, Tracy. Passes back to the wing. Schultz. Kirkby grabs the rebound.
Credit the defense there.
They got out on him, and they forced him to rush it a little.
Okay. I also have to put in my book now. He's going to graduate as someone different. Down with it, though. It's ridiculous, and I like that. Does he have a degree? Don't even know my own commands. What am I doing here? What am I doing here? Paulding, Zhang, Dupree. Yeah. Okay.
He's got 13. Dupre brings it up the floor. Schultz. Has it right block. No good in the last layup. Down to 52. Last shot, they gently in.
Oh, the reverse. Dynamic move around the 10 that time.
The kicker is, it won't even matter unless we win this game. We gotta win this game.
Left side with the shot. Hauled in by McCollum, and that's his ninth rebound thus far.
They've gotta learn to be patient on offense. Good shots will come if you don't rush them.
Sometimes the meatballs roll your way, sometimes they don't. They're cheering, will you will miss.
Inbounds the ball. Wilcox catches it. Top of the key. Garnett takes the three. Loveless grabs the rebound inside. Right around 9 minutes left in the second half.
He did a real good job to stay that close on a shooter. Just getting a hand up will bother most players enough to make the miss.
Loose and it's scooped up by Wilcox.
Listen to the crowd burn. This kind of excitement is why I love
The fact that we're not stopping people there is really, really bad.
Schultz takes it up, gets whistled for a foul. That's his first personal foul. The 3-point play. Gets it in the paint. That last layup was missed by Wilcox. The break is on.
This guy can usually finish in traffic, but the D was too good, even for him on that one.
Number 52 passes to the top of the key. Schultz takes it up. They bring their lead to 7. Left wing, from deep. It's ripped down by number 52.
Sochu has missed quite a few shots in a row now, and it's unavoidable.
Up seven now.
Affecting his confidence.
Schultz from
It's just a pass. Oh, Andy gets the and one. Meatballs once. Meatball wants Dupree to change his name. Just a complete normal thing.
Bounces it to the right. Huffman dishes to the right. Haxton has it top of the key, puts it up. The run couldn't be stopped on the attempt by Huffman. Right around 7 minutes left in the second half.
Huffman, considering how much he's been struggling, they're lucky it's still tied up. If he could just give them a little bit more offense, they'd be in great shape.
Pass down low. Wilkins has it, and that's his sixth rebound.
Lovelace is just so weak inside. Oh, good work. That's why we have long wings. And one from the little man. Hell yeah. Incredible work. Love it. Love it. Back to back fast break point. Are we up 15? Incredible. This is a good team. I thought this might be the end of a four-peat. It might just be a back to back.
Thanks, Tracy. Haxton has it left wing. Huffman dumps it off. Haxton skips it to the left wing. Cannot stop the drop. Number 52 has been lights out. They gotta find a way to stop this onslaught.
Well, the best defense can be a good offense, and they don't seem to have one right now.
Passes it to the wing.
With a leader like Meatballs, the mountain is too high. Meatballs isn't our leader. He's a sophomore, man. It's all about Schultz and Dupree. 18 fouls already. 1-1, beautiful. He's like the soul of the team though, fair.
Inbounds the ball. Goes up. The finger roll was leaded by Kirkman. He's 2-for-4 for the game. Western Illinois carries it up. They're on a 14-4 run. Loud fires. Ludwig pulls it down. From inside. Too strong. But they're still up by 14. Swing pass, left wing. Garnett. catches it. Right wing. Hexka knocks down the trifecta. He's shooting 50% from beyond the arc. Loveless hands it off. Right side. Backs in. Number 52 shoots. Grabs the rock.
All right. I guess that was one time long range shot.
Just shake it off and move on. Bounces it to the high post. Garnett.
Still up 11. Looks like Dupree's going to get his name changed.
Dishes it to the stripe. Huffman from long range. Sixman. He's 2 for 5 from downtown. Western Illinois has been on the wrong side of this long run. And Tracy's got a report for us.
Schultz just wants to put it up. You're 8 inches taller than this man. Just do it. You just have those ups. Unless you think your Jay is like that much shorter. There you go. You have a child guarding you. Do it. Actually, it would be like me guarding him, but you know. I'm 5'11½. If I was to guard a 6'7 absolute sniper from 3, all he should do is just jump and shoot. He's going to... what am I going to do? Put my hand in his face? It's the best thing I could possibly do. I like how we're slowing it down a bit. This is good. I'm allowed to round 5 and 11½ up to 6 feet. I mean, yeah, but like, it's also the truth. I'm not quite 6. I sort of wish I was like 6'2 or like 5'5. I already have difficulty buying clothing, and my feet are too big for many for shopping for many sizes of shoes. So I might as well go all in either way, right? Just like average girl height, making my life easy, or like just full Amazon ass.
2 minutes remaining. Schultz brings it up.
Oh my God, no. Tall girl's good. I mean, fair. 5'11½ isn't quite tall enough for women's big and tall stores. I don't... What women's big and tall stores, Ray? Which women's big and tall stores? Ones that don't exist, my dude. Makinde is experienced enough. I don't like Lovelace being out there. I'd rather actually just have Jason Maxiao. Tony Meatballs. Yep.
Substitution on the court.
Both teams will bring in some fresh legs here.
Up by 3. 2 minutes left. Put in sure-handed people.
What are we doing? What are we doing? What are we doing?
Loveless inbounds the ball.
We went back to our starters. The CPU has money on this. The fuck was that? No, fuck it. This game's gonna...
It's contagious, Vern. One guy starts hitting, it looks a lot easier for the rest of them. Before you know it, everybody's getting into the act. Last shot missed by Dupree.
Fuck it. Two bad quick shots.
Has it right wing.
Just give it to Tony. Give it to the meats.
Passes cross court. It's deflected.
Okay, thank God we still have possession.
Lovely. Inbounds the ball.
Man, just give it to Lau. Let him shoot.
Lovely.
Don't let.
Dishes to the left.
Dupree for three.
Can't put an end to the run.
He gets it.
Pick up his second.
That's his second personal foul.
They need to get back as soon as possible.
Short.
That's
picked up
his first foul of the game.
That's it. A first personal foul.
Which is just what the foul.
And that's why they did it. Time is not on their side. Very smart play.
Short.
He gets
picked up his second foul.
That's his second personal foul.
They've got to stop the clock and get the ball down right away.
Schultz just picked up his third foul again.
That's his third personal foul.
The foul stops the clock, which is just what the doctor ordered.
And that's why they did it. Time is not on their side. Very smart play.
Schultz
now has four fouls.
That's his fourth personal foul.
They need the ball back as soon as possible.
Penalty situation.
McCollum inbounds the ball.
Deep into the foul.
That's his third personal foul.
7 points.
Choice but the foul. They've got to stop the clock and get the ball back right away.
Knocks it down.
If he misses, we can put up a three. Two possession game.
Great job to make it a two possession ball game.
To stop the run. Hit the left eye.
Game.
Missed by Schultz.
Number 56.
Missed the foul.
That's his second personal foul.
I can appreciate their willingness to keep battling, Vern, but I think it's too late to save the game. Fouling isn't going to do them any good anymore.
There's no reason. This had to happen.
Sinks the first one. And that puts them up by five. Gets the ball, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Two threes, pass and shoot.
Schultz launches it. Off the mark.
Deep into the foul.
We're in the bonus.
I'm refunding you.
Sinks the first one, and that makes it a 7-point lead.
I don't want to sully his name.
Two for two, and it's an 8-point ball game. Lovely inbounds the ball. That's the end of the game. The Bulls defeat Western Illinois. 86-78. They're on their way to the national championship game. Now let's go back to Greg Gumbel with today's version of the Pontiac game-changing performance.
Thanks, Vern. Welcome, everyone, to 2K Sports Studios. I'm Greg Gumbel with today's version of the Pontiac game-changing performance. In a close game like this, winners and losers are determined by who keeps their composure during crunch time. The South Florida Bulls dug down deep to deliver this amazing shot late in the game. This shot broke the backs of the opponent and put the game away. A tremendous effort from the young man.
Thanks, Greg. For Tracy Wilson, Bill Raftery, and all of us here at 2K Sports, thanks for watching this presentation of
this night. Made me really hopeful that this team would succeed. The game decided that they wouldn't. When we shoot 4 for 23 from 3, that'll do it to you. Dupree just needs to shoot. All I do is shoot. Who's way bigger than his opponent. 44 points in the paint. Oh for 9 from Schultz. Oh for 9 for literally the best 3-point shooter I've ever fucking seen. We're just gonna he's a 97. He's rated 90. His matchup was 5-3. He's rated 97 and he's 6'7". His matchup was 5'11". His defense stats high, but his vert's not tremendously great. About equal to Schultz's. Butt came in and shot 3 times. Why was Prado in the game? Bukinde didn't have the best minutes, but he did fine. Jason Maxiel only had 4 minutes. Three turnovers from Schultz.